Good Friday, Malaysians. You're still tuned in to Bernama Today with me, Deepa, and I have a very special, very handsome, dashing actor beside me today, Stephen Rahman Hughes. How are you doing today?
Yeah, very good. Thank you very much. How are you?
How was the KL traffic? I'm good.
Yeah, turn around, that was a little bit
messy,
bit
isn't it?
Yeah, very messy.
Well, if you haven't already know this, Stephen is an engaging, versatile performer, and his career has spanned from stage, TV, and film. Starting the industry as a dancer and a multi-award-winning choreographer.
Yeah.
Will you still do dance?
If I'm asked to, I will do, yeah.
Right.
So if I'm in musical shows and obviously there's some choreography, obviously I'll have to get my dancing shoes back out again.
Right. So you may remember him from Hikayat Merong Mawangsa not too long ago, and he has appeared in numerous leading roles in plays and musicals and so many other things that you probably... You haven't done commercials yet.
Actually, I just feel I'm in KL at the moment just to film one, so you'll see me on the box.
So we'll see him on
boxes. In a few days' time.
All right. So today we're going to talk about Stephen's new album, but before that, I have to ask you: when did you first realize your passion for performing?
I think at a young age, I was always a bit of an exhibitionist in some sense, but you know, in the usual kind of Asian way, my mother kind of sent me more towards wanting me to be a lawyer or a doctor or an accountant or something like that. And I quickly realized that being in an office wasn't really, my personality wasn't suited to that environment. So I did a bit of traveling and I think I kind of found myself. And when I got back to England, I ended up making the choice and ended up joining a theater group and started from there. Dancing really was my main sort of career in the beginning. And that kind of changed from musicals, film and TV.
Right. Now you chose the unconventional way. Instead of being a lawyer, you decided to become a performer. So who's your biggest inspiration when you started performing?
I think mostly for me it was kind of the people that were around me at the time when I was training. A lot of mentors, a lot of people that believed in me. You know, when some people were telling me that I would never be a dancer just because, you know, people have trained you since they're 3 years old. Same with acting, same with singing. But I think just people telling you with a bit of hard work and, you know, some raw talent there and shape it well. And it's those people that really, for me, are my sort of mentors and idols. And then obviously, you know, in the acting profession, there are people like, I mean, I love to watch Ed Harris, Judi Dench, I think, is a fantastic actress.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there are so many of them.
Now, probably that's why the reason you've been appearing in West End plays for a long time. Tell us about your appearances in West End. How was that all about? How was that like, the experience?
Yeah, it was fun. I mean, I played a character called Akash in Bombay Dreams. So I had to sort of talk, you know, with an Indian accent. And it was a lot of fun. It was a Bollywood star. It was like from rags to riches story, from a slum to a Bollywood star. And it was kind of very similar to my own life in a sense, because I didn't come from a well-to-do background. There wasn't a lot of money around and it was quite difficult, tough upbringing. So I kind of connected with that part really well. And I think that helped me in the role and it got me noticed. And from then, I have not looked back, so. It's been a pretty amazing journey.
Now, you've been recently nominated for the drama and TV film TV festival in Monte Carlo for Kitchen the Musical. Tell us about your experience for Kitchen the Musical. How was it like working with the other actors and the cast?
I mean, it was great. There were sort of stars from around the region, Philippines. We had a supermodel on the show from Hong Kong, you know, pop stars from the Philippines, an actor out of New York. And then myself, I was kind of representing Malaysia, if you like. The show was in English, and I was a chef. I was the executive chef on the show, and I was sort of one minute I was chopping onions, and the next minute I was singing big, huge numbers.
Right, chopping onions and singing. I think women do that on a daily basis in the kitchen, anyways. So now your new album is in Malay.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. I think you told me that you have sung in Malay before for Hikayat Merong Mawangsa.
No, Puchu Gunung Leda.
Puchu Gunung Leda. Yeah. I'm sorry. So do you find it difficult to sing in Malay since you don't speak on a daily basis? You don't really regularly converse in Malay, do you?
It's not difficult to sing. I think it just takes a bit more time to really get to know the songs and understand the lyrics because I have to, you know, I have to kind of work on three layers. I work with the English first, so I understand what the song's about. Mm-hmm. Then I work with the Malay, the translation. So I'm working between those translations, and then I go word for word. And then it's, you know, like an actor would. Then you go into what it means to you, what the things that it connects to in your life, and then you try and make that as real as possible. So by the time you sing the song, you know, the message is hopefully clear.
Tell us about the composers behind this album. Well, are they local or? Do you know them?
Yes, we had a couple of composers from Indonesia and some prominent composers from Malaysia, which are Odi Mok, and Aslan Abu Hassan and Kevin Chin.
Now, the songs that have been written in this album, are they based on real life experiences? Can we track down some of your journal?
Well, I think that's the whole thing. I mean, they were written for me, but the thing is for me is then to make them my own. So you make them into your own experiences.
So
you connect them to experiences of your life so that they do mean something to you.
So you could relate to the lyrics?
Yeah.
They are somehow related to your real life?
Yeah, I mean, lots of the lyrics are... there are a couple of songs, nice, epic, sort of rich ballads that are very sort of universal in theme. You know, love stories, you know, things about, you know, a love that transcends, you know, the here and now and stuff like that. It's very, very romantic.
So it's the self-titled album here that you've just recently cut, and some of the songs that's playing in the background right now. So could you tell us, between acting, singing and dancing, which art would you say is your favourite?
No, it's tough. I get asked that a lot. My training and my dance career, it was magical, you know, to have that physical ability when you're just jumping in the air and spending, you know, you've got the sort of right technique and muscularity to stay in the air for a long time, stuff like that. It's a great feeling. You almost feel subhuman. But I mean, for me at the moment, I love my singing. The singing is the thing that always makes me happy. As soon as I'm singing, I'm happy.
Right. So you told us that recently you've cut a TV drama in Morocco called The Bible. How was that? What was that all about?
I played a character called Lemuel, and it's a sort of pre sort of any of the writings from the Bible or, you know, anything around that period. And it's obviously all these characters are recognized through lots of different religions, but this was the Bible's perspective on those stories. And I'm in the first episode where I play a character with Abraham's clan, and I'm kind of a shepherd that sort of likes to fight.
So did you have to handle sheep, really? Herd sheep?
No? Yeah, goats,
really?
Mainly.
Goats?
Yeah.
Goats in Morocco?
Yeah, that was very smelly at the end of the day.
How long was this production?
I was out there for 3 weeks.
3 weeks? Oh, that's fairly short.
Yeah, but the production is still shooting. It started shooting in January and will probably finish in July.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's a long, very, very big production.
Now, going back to your album, is there a personal favourite that you like from all the songs, the 8 songs?
I don't know, at the moment I'm kind of listening to Kulapas because I really love the melody. I think I like Expressi because it's got a bit of an edge to it, Odimok. And then I think the first track that I recorded was Bertemudi Shurga.
All right.
And I think for me that's always going to hold a very dear place to me because it was the first one. It was the first one that I got to perform in front of an audience as well.
Where were all the songs recorded? Were they in Kuala Lumpur?
I think I've recorded one in Singapore and the rest were in KL.
I'm sorry, you said Kulapas, right?
Yeah.
Which number is that in the song?
Number 8.
Number 8?
Yes, the last one.
Okay, we'll probably play it later on.
Okay,
now, what do you have in the pipelines? What are your future plans, Stephen?
I go back to England and first of all I have to go to Monte Carlo and go to the Drama Awards, and I hope all these my big idols will be there, Ed Harris, Steve Buscemi, Dominic West, some of these, you know, fantastic actors that I really look up to. So we'll be hitting the red carpet with them. And then after that I have some concerts with two other very big West End stars in London, and we're going to tour the UK for a bit.
Now, with such a busy schedule, you're managing your professional life, do you find time to, you know, go out there and break away from all this and, you know, probably go travelling, you know, on your own time?
Yeah,
or
something
else?
I usually fly to actually come here. I go to Tioman. I part own a scuba diving centre, BJ Dive Centre.
Have you been diving for a long time now?
Yeah, I've been diving for years. I'm a dive master and I've stayed at dive master for a very, very long time. My cousin's trying to get me up to instructor, but I don't want to do that because you just sit on the beach teaching people.
That's kind of interesting. I would you know, think that would be some of my friends' dream job, to just sit on the beach and every day, you know, that's your job. So other than that, what do you find interesting? What is most interesting about this album? What is so appealing? What can the audience expect from this album?
I think it's just, you know, for especially for Malaysia, you know, it's got that epic kind of ballady feel. I mean, obviously, there's a couple of pop songs in there, one that's got slight rock edge. And I think there is a song for everybody, and it's very easy to connect to. You know, it's very rich. It's a great soundtrack to put on in the car when it's raining and the traffic's jammed, and I think people
just sing
really
along to the lyrics while you're in a we're stuck in a traffic jam.
I think it's going to be a perfect karaoke CD at some point.
Karaoke, that's great. I mean, I wouldn't imagine any artist, you know, promoting their album as a karaoke, but
no,
you might be the
first. What I mean is, those songs, they're so catchy.
Right.
So I imagine people will be hitting the karaoke.
Have they begun playing in the radio? Are they on?
They're starting to play on the radio now. Just started, yeah.
So what kind of promotional tours are you planning? Have you done any promotional tours for this album?
Well, that's why I'm here this week.
All right.
To try and plug the album. And then we're looking toward maybe at the end of the month, me coming back and just holding sort of an intimate kind of concert just to introduce the material to the KL audience. And then from there, hopefully we'll be planning bigger and better concerts.
So have you been receiving any positive feedbacks? Do you have any response?
Already it's just been released and already there's feedback. I mean, and what's really nice is people on Facebook and Twitter are telling me that they have different favourite tracks. You know, you always think that one will be an outstanding track, but it's really nice to know that there must be, you know, most of the tracks on here, all the tracks are very different and very strong. So, and everybody has a favourite.
Now, for you out there who are interested in listening to Steven's new album, you can check out the info in his website, which is at www.stevenrahman-hughes.com for more information on your latest events. Are you planning on any other musicals? What are your musical plans for now?
I mean, there's talk of doing the Kitchen musical season 2.
There's a sequel.
So, yeah. So, because it's so popular, I mean, it's winning awards. I mean, we're having to fly all around the planet to different award ceremonies and... you know, with it picking up all these awards and all this really nice recognition, I think that it's only right that they should put another season together.
Well, Steven, I wish you all the best with this new album, and thank you for watching Burnama today. And we will see you next week, the same time, same place. So, goodbye.
See ya.